Assalamu alaikum, everyone. I'm your friend Kashi. Welcome to Kashi Digital Headquarter. So this is our second session of Introduction to AI, Artificial Intelligence, AI-101. Previous session and this session both are the fundamental of this learning series. So let's get started. So first, a disclaimer, simply words are my own and I'm just sharing my knowledge with you guys. This is the entire series that you see for all the sessions that we'll be covering. Today, we will cover session number 2 for this beginner essential AI series. And then we will have many hands-on sessions afterwards and demos. So let's first review what we covered in the last session. So if you have not seen the video of the previous session, I will highly recommend please go watch the video by visiting kashiahmad.com. Right? In our previous session, what we learned is we learned some interesting facts about the AI, history of AI, the level of AI, and also biggest achievement of AI. We also learned about some of the concept of different tools that we can use for the AI. We explained different between AI machine learning and deep learning and AI, and also how they relate to each other. And then we also saw some real world examples. To build the foundation of this knowledge and to have fun during this course, watch previous session and this session. So let's see what our session number 2 is all about. So in this episode, we are going to learn everything about what's the buzz about this generative AI or LLM, which is large language model. And what is prompt? What is prompting? How does it relate to gen AI or LLM? And let's understand these concepts. So the concept that we understand before and this one, that will help us with the rest of the course. So let's get started. First, we will learn about LLM, but before LLM, large language model, let's talk about what a language model, right? Are you ready? So the language model, they are type of artificial intelligence program, software program, that can generate natural language responses. They were like taking the series of the words that you're writing and history and the context, and they try to predict the next possible word that you're trying to use. For example, when you go to Google and you try to search that what is the, you will see the list of all the options that it tried to predict. Maybe you're searching for this. It's all based on your history, the location, and most popular search by the people. So that's what it is all about. So this model suggests most possible completion of your sentences. That's called language model. It helps you find things faster and easier. So hopefully that understand this. All the search engines use that method. These are language models. What are large language models? And they call it LLM, right? That's what it stands for. Whenever you heard the name LLM, that means large language model. They are powerful AI tools that can understand and generate language, natural language responses. They can do like amazing things. For example, they can create stories, write entire essays for you. They can create images by giving a text prompt for them. For example, if you have heard about ChatGPT, it is a text-based LLM. So it is text-based large language model, LLM, and that can have a conversation with you, two-way conversation, right? It has back and forth. It can learn from your messaging and history what you're working. It can keep the context and reply to you in the engaging and out more like natural language. There's another LLM. So all different LLMs are purpose-built. ChatGPT is using text-based LLM, which crawled the entire internet and did that. Second version is like, for example, text-to-image LLM, which is Midjourney, very popular. That's text-to-image-based LLM. It can take the description of what you're trying to ask to draw, and it can like take this scene and everything and draw that for you, more like realistic color and all this. So these are two examples. There are more other different type of LLM like this, like code-based LLM, which are useful for generating the coding, programming languages and all those. So these are the different ways the LLM that we interact. And this technology is changing the way we work with computer software. So now we understand LLMs, we understand language model. Let's understand what is generative AI. And the easiest way to understand the generative AI, if we understand and look into from in contrast with predictive AI. So let's talk about that. So predictive and generative AI, both of them are the type of artificial intelligence that uses large language model. Predictive AI, it uses the data and algorithms to it forecast future outcome based on events and happen or in the past or in the present data. So it look at the past data, present data, and it try to predict what's coming next. For example, if you want to take a predictive example, it could be telling you the next best action or next product that you more like on the Amazon, or next movie that you want to watch on Netflix, or a chatbot or a support chatbot with trying to give you the product suggestions or article or solution. These are all example of predictive AI. Now, generative AI, it also uses the data and algorithms to create new and original content based on existing data. So it's also using existing data, it's trying to generate the new responses to you. For example, it can generate insights and summaries. You're looking at the whole article on the web page and it can generate the summary for you. It can personalize the search result or bot assistant, which understanding your query and talking to you in a more human way. It can also, as we talked about mid-journey, it generates some art, images, text, audio, videos, and all this. And it can have a conversation with you like you and I are having right now. It wouldn't feel that it is a computer you are talking to. So therefore, predictive AI and generative AI, both are using LLM, but two different ways. And they analyze and create data. They have different use cases and application, but they both rely on the power of large language models. That's easy way to understand. If you understand predictive, you can understand the generative AI. Now, let's dig a little bit deeper onto the generative AI part. So generative AI is like a digital artist that can learn from your existing data, your sources, your environment, and it can produce original and realistic work. For example, it can write a new song for you, compose a new music for you, draw a picture based on the input that you provide. So you see on the left side, you can provide input, which we call prompt, right? It could be a word, it could be a phrase, a sentence, image, voice or code, and it can generate, it goes to the black box AI algorithm. In the first lesson, we learn about the black box of AI, the algorithms and all the computations are happening. It can do it, it can do magic and computation and generate the new original text, image, voice, or code for you. In simplistic term, you can take out different previous type of data and it can produce the new unique output based on your input, and the input are called prompts. But let's also look at the popularity of generative AI and some facts. Why it's so popular right now? So generative AI, it did brought a new disruption in this era, and it has been adopted exponentially by faster than any app or devices that we have seen, like Facebook, TikTok, and etc. As a matter of fact, if I tell you, it took only 5 days to ChatGPT to reach to 1 million users. How many days it took to reach it 100 million users? Only 2 months. In contrast, it took TikTok, which was a very viral app, is a viral app, 9 months to reach 100 million users. And it took 2 years, 6 months to Instagram. And it's not that in the past. Instagram recently, a few years ago. So that's the adoption of generative AI. Now, let's talk about prompt and prompting and how to write better prompt and how they're related to generative AI. So this section, we will learn what is called prompt, as I was saying, prompt, and how you, what are the best practice, and what is prompt engineering. So what is prompt? Prompt is simply a specific input instructions that you are giving to a language model, large language model, which is a computer program that we talked about, AI program, that can generate the natural language responses to you. That's the input. For example, if you want a model to answer a question, like write a story or explain something, or you need to give it a prompt and tell it what to do. You need to explain what to do. And the quality of and relevance of the output depends on largely on the prompt, how complete and clear and concise and specific the prompt is. The more clear you are, more specific you are, the better the results from the AI you will have. So that is simply a prompt. Now, what is prompt engineering? Prompt engineering is the process of using prompt. Prompting is important for AI interactive AI application that rely on the natural language processing, such as ChatGPT, chatbot, content generation, text completion, and prompting helps to direct the AI and output based on the user intent and the goal. Prompting can also help you avoid unwanted responses from the AI. Again, if you want a better answer for the generative AI, you need to write a better prompt. But now we should ask, how do I write a better prompt? What are the guidance around writing a better prompt? Well, let's look into it. So when writing a prompt, simply I would suggest is just don't say, make my social media campaign. Give it some detail like, make a social media campaign for a website that sells t-shirts with movies and comics like Star Wars. Now you're giving a little bit more context to it. Okay? You should talk to it like you're talking to a friend. Use simple words, sentences, don't be like Shakespeare. You're talking to a friend like a simple language. Do not make it too hard. You can, when it responds to you, you can ask questions that encourage detailed responses. Go back and forth. And open-ended question. Don't say yes and no kind of question. You can also include some personas. Ask it like someone you know in this style, like Einstein. Someone who does things like a manager. Someone who buys something like a customer. You can also define audience and channel. Explain if it is for young people, older people, high schooler, professional, or if you need something for the Twitter, or you need something for LinkedIn posts and all those, a blog, a store website, to give some channel or audience. You can ask some follow-up question to it too. Like you need more information, ask more question about it, get the better responses. So, and when you write prompt, you can follow basic structure, which is you do the action, you start with the action, you provide context, and you say what kind of output you want. Right? The more complex structure exists already, but this is to just for us to get started, this should be good enough. I put an example here saying, like, write a short story about a dog. That's the action. We want you to write the story. It goes to an adventure in the park. That's the context. And use imagination. Like, or you can do output, what kind of output you want. Now, if you don't follow these basic structure or these best practices, what will happen is you will end up having a situation like hallucination, or you would need to start grounding the response. So these are the two terms you will hear. Hallucination and grounding with large language. Now let's look into it, what those are. So let's first understand what grounding is from simple example. So think of ChatGPT as your helpful friend that we talked about. Sometimes it needs a clear instruction to get the best answer. But grounding means giving it a very clear, specific instruction, like you're talking to a friend, as we saw in the best practice. So you can have more accurate and concise answer. Now, if you do not provide this whole information to that, what will happen, something really interesting thing will happen, like hallucination. Hallucination involves AI to generate the response, which is very plausible, but it may have inaccurate information. To avoid this, you need to have crystal clear information. But don't rely 100% on the AI. You always have to make sure the information is accurate. There was an example, a lawyer actually submitted a case to a judge. It has referenced a lot of cases in the past, which was not real cases. It just made up those cases. Not all the information is real, right? So that's why you still need to verify the facts. Now, another important thing is each language model are trained on certain data and certain date. So you have to make sure that if it is, you're asking something which is related, and I'll give you an example, it may not provide you a good response. So let's see some example of grounding and hallucination to better understand how they work. So here's a hands-on exercise that I would like you guys to do. So you guys should go chat.openai.com and sign up. I would recommend signing up using Google sign up, Microsoft sign up, Apple sign up, so you don't have to go a lot of verification. It will ask for your date of birth and phone number. You need to have your phone number. And write a prompt. Explain how ChatGPT works. And review the prompt. You will see how much detail it provides you. Right? Then you can ground the prompt by saying, explain how ChatGPT works using a simple analogy. And you see the response will be shorter. Then you can further ground it and say, explain how it works using a very simple analogy with a fewer word possible And now you will see the explanation will become a couple of lines and all this. So this is called grounding. Here, let me see if I can zoom in. For this one, here I provided a response using a simple analogy, and you can see how it did all the detail. And then you say a fewer words, then it will give you fewer words. Now, let's look at hallucination. This is another hands-on activity I will highly advise you to do. The interesting fact here is, what I did is very simple. What you can do is provide ChatGPT a prompt that asks ChatGPT to give you an example of hallucination. You don't have to worry about it. What do I ask it? ChatGPT was trained on the data by September 2021. So anything you ask for the latest event after September 2021, it may not have an answer. It might be hallucination on this, or maybe some interesting fact in the past. So what I did is I put a prompt there. You can copy this prompt. Is, can you provide me an example of hallucination issue that can occur with the OpenAI large language model element? So it actually gave me an example saying, okay, why don't you, if you look at it, you say, why don't you ask me if you, in the past, when people ask, describe the history of space exploration and first moon landing. And here you can see when you ask this prompt, it actually did some hallucination because it talked about hidden civilization living on the moon. This is not a fact. This is not factual information. It made it up, but it sounds good when you read through it. So that's an example of hallucination. Now I would highly advise you to do this. I'll create a separate video to show hallucination, this example, and post it. So look into that. Now, let's summarize what we learned in this session. Right? So we learned about ChatGPT, we learned about generative AI and prompting, how ChatGPT is like a friend, sign up on ChatGPT, provide some prompt to it. ChatGPT is one of the large language models. We'll learn more about large language model, different type of text to text, one text to next sessions. So stay tuned, look into prompting. Prompt is just giving instruction and input to the large language model. Now let's see another example of how the Gen AI work with the text to image kind of. So we've learned two type of model, text to text, ChatGPT, text to image, we reference Midjourney. Now there are other text to image large language model as well. DALL-E 2 is also by OpenAI. So when you sign up for OpenAI, click on DALL-E 2 and use some prompt. Here I used a prompt saying, draw a high quality photo of an astronaut riding a horse on the moon. Just use DALL-E, provide this prompt, a blue willow, or one highly recommended tool, I would say Adobe Firefly. It's free. Go to Adobe website, Firefly. Use this prompt and you will see how image they created. It created this image for us. Very realistic image. Right? And the prompt, another example, you saw the prompt at the bottom. I have the prompt where it says, a cute, fluffy blue ball animal running through magical forest trying to catch a firefly. And it created this fluffy animal and that's walking through the forest. So that's how the generative AI and prompting works. Now, if you want to dive into more into prompting and generative AI, and people who are more technical, or students or professional, I will highly recommend you can take this introduction course on Coursera. Deep learning AI will have a lot of short courses. I would recommend to take one of the prompting course for developers. Google AI also have a good article about prompting design. Take that. You will learn more about complex prompting. And definitely, highly recommend you to sign up for ChatGPT and play with right now. For this, just play with ChatGPT and DALL-E 2. Now, let's take a sneak peek in our next session, what we're going to talk about in our next lesson. And now we build the foundation for what is AI, what is Gen AI, what is prompt, what is LLM. Now we are going to have more fun. We're going to talk about all the large language models. We'll explore each one of them. And first one, we're going to explore text-to-text chat tool, more famous tool. We have OpenAI, we have Bing Chat, which use OpenAI 4.0. I'll tell you why OpenAI is so unique, why it is different, and we'll talk about all the buzz that is going in the industry. We'll look into Google Bard, another large LLM for the text-to-text, and Anthropic Cloud 2, which is a free open source one. We'll look into that, and we'll see more example of this. Now there will be fun session. So highly recommend to watch these two sessions, sign up for the, and keep an eye on to the next session. And how do you keep an eye for the next session? My simple ask to you guys is, please visit kashiema.com. Follow me, Kashi DHQ, Kashi Digital Headquarter, on any social media platform. If you like what you learned, right, give me a thumbs up, subscribe, hit the bell icon, share these content to the folks. I'm converting this content into multiple languages using AI, and Hindi and Urdu, I'm recording it. So please share with any South Asian population for this that can get benefit out of this session. And when you go to my website, there's a subscribe button. You can put your email there. You will get an email whenever the new video is launched, and that will keep you up to date. Again, thank you for listening to me. I hope you enjoyed what I had to share in these short videos, and I'll see you next time. With that, Allah Hafiz.